The first thing we're going to do is we're going to implement a custom health check. We're then going to start building our own custom data and our own metrics, the metrics that we actually care about. We're going to build those into the metrics endpoint. Okay, the first thing we're going to do is we're going to implement this custom health check. And the purpose of this check is to allow us to make our own decision when it comes to whether or not the API is up and running or it's considered down. So for example, we might want to check the persistence layer and make sure that persistence is working. We might also want to check any sort of external dependency that we have, like for example, a caching layer and make sure that's working. So any sort of check that will basically determine if the system is up and running or not. So let's do that. The interface that drives this entire health check is pretty simple. It only has one method, and it essentially allows us to build whatever type of check we want inside that method. Okay, so we now have a very simple implementation that, of course, doesn't yet do anything. We still have to build the health object, and of course, the check itself, we are not going to build that right now. But at this point, we can pretty much do whatever check we want, because this is a Spring component. So we could, for example, inject one of our repositories, and we could do a read query and just make sure that works. We could do pretty much any check we want, so we won't worry about that too much, but we will build out the health method there, and we'll also try to simulate a failed health check, and we'll see how that looks in the endpoint. Alright, so it doesn't get any simpler than this. We now have this simple check here that basically says that something is indeed wrong in the system. And in case something's wrong, we're going to try to simulate an out of service. So let's see how this runs and how this looks in the endpoint. Alright, so with the system running and with the custom health check that simulates a failure, let's run this and let's see what it looks like. So first off, the status code. The health check endpoint is smart enough not only to pick up that custom health check that we just built, but it's also smart enough to return the right type of status code, 503 service unavailable, besides the body. So the JSON body should also say service unavailable, but the status code, of course, also reflects that. So let's have a look at the body. And here we go. We're getting the right type of status, so it's clear that our custom health check actually works and actually determines the outcome of the entire health endpoint. Okay, so let's now move towards the metrics endpoint and let's start tracking some custom metrics. We saw the many types of metrics that are available to us in that metrics endpoint already out of the box. But we actually also want to track something custom. So let's say we want to track how many times this find by name operation has been called. So we want something along the lines of find by name specifically for a privilege has been called, let's say, 100 times. So we want to track that information and we want to make that available to us in our metrics monitoring system, whatever that is, even if that's the JSON endpoint. So let's set that up. And it is really that simple. We've injected the counter service. This is the service out of the Spring Boot support. And we are now simply incrementing this key. The syntax of this key is also pretty simple. We're working with service just to make sure that we are pointing to the right layer. We are in the service layer here. We are then specifying the type of data we're working on. So we're going with privilege. And then we are going with the operation. Now, of course, the syntax is simply a string, so we could have anything we want here, but this is a simple and clean way to track data and to be able to make sense of it later on. And the very quick side note here is that although this is very simple, and it is definitely simple as you can see here, it is highly useful. It's a very powerful way to keep track of any sort of data we want. We can do this at the service level, we could do it in the controller layer as well. We can basically keep track of any sort of metric we want here, and that is super powerful. Alright, hope you enjoyed this section from Course 8 of REST with Spring, and of course, to go deeper into the metrics of the API, check out the full course at restwithspring.com. Have fun with this one, and see you in the next one.